Hi everyone, this is Dikshit. Welcome to my channel. In this particular video, I'll be talking about difference between poll SCM and build periodically. These are the two methods by which we can trigger our build. So let's get into our demo. So I have already my Jenkins up and running. So let me create a job. Let me name it my job as a triggers test. Underscore test. So this is, I'll basically take it as a freestyle job. So let's save it. And then click on, there is something, two things. So one is you can see build periodically and poll SCM. Okay. So let me take my source code, my source code is there in GitHub. That's the reason I'll select Git. Okay, so let me take any one of the repo. So let me take this sample web application and I'll take the branch as master. So let me take this URL, clone URL, and let me give it here. So as this is a public repository, so I don't want to select anything here. So I'm giving my branch as master. Okay, just click on save. So I'll trigger my job by using build periodically. Okay. So what I'll do, I'll select this particular, this one. So when you click on this question mark, right? So it says this is basically a cron tab. So, the five digits will be there. The first digit is minutes. Second digit is hours. And third digit is day of a month. And fourth digit is month in a year. And, the fifth digit is the day of the week. Okay. So what I'll do is as it is a demo. So every minute I'll run my I'll give a cron tab as 5 stars. That means my job will be triggered every 5 minutes. Okay. Not every 5 minutes. Sorry. Every 1 minute, my job will be triggered. If you see here, so specify all valid values. That means I'm giving, if you see here, do you really mean every minute? My job should be run. Okay, so just click on save. Okay, so let's wait for 1 minute. Now if you see the time, so it's 17:29, so let me pause it so until it triggers a build. Okay, so now our time is 17:30, so my build has been triggered. If you see the console now, so now basically see, if I have triggered manually, so it says triggered by an anonymous user or whatever the user, it has been triggered. So if you see here, started by timer, that means my build periodically is properly working. Okay. And so why, how build periodically works is every minute it will gonna run, either if there is a change in Git repo or if no changes are there in Git repo. So regardless of that, so as you can see, one more build came into picture as it is 1 minute. So every 1 minute, so it will run my job. It will try to trigger my job because I've set my timer as 1 minute, right? So it doesn't see whether there is a change in your GitHub repo or not. It will continuously, it will trigger whatever the time specified by you. So this is how build periodically works. So let me change the configuration. So click on configure. So what I'll do is I'll just disable this particular option, build periodically. So I'll just give poll SCM. Again, this is a cron tab. Okay. So what I'll do, I'll give star again here. So 5 stars. So every minute my job should be triggered. So how poll SCM works is so it will check a git, your repository. So whatever the clone link you have given, right? So it'll try to see, is there any changes in that particular GitHub or not? So if it is there, then only it will trigger a job. Okay. If it is not there, then it won't trigger build at all. Okay. So now it's 17:32, right? So we will wait till 17:33. So let's check whether it will gonna trigger the build or not. Okay. So again, I'm telling if you take a build periodically, so every 1 minute, so either there is a change or there is no change, your build will be triggered. So we have seen, right? So if you see build 2 also, it says started by timer. Okay. So now, so So now we have changed our configuration to a poll SCM, so which will be basically here. If you see here, so it will be under trigger section. Okay, so I've given poll SCM. So every 1 minute, so it will gonna first check my GitHub. Okay, so if any changes are there in my GitHub, then it will trigger a job in Jenkins. Okay, so if it is not there, then it won't trigger a build at all, build in my Jenkins. Okay. So now, as you can see, it is 1733. So the build has not triggered. Okay. So now what I'll do is, so I'll do little, I mean, changes in any one of the file in my GitHub. Okay. So let me do some small changes. So I'll just enter a space and just commit it. Okay. Now this is 733, right? So I guess like it will gonna trigger our job on 1734, or it might take 1 more minute, so it might trigger my job on 1735. Okay, so let's wait for that. And also few more things I can discuss meanwhile. So few more things I can give you idea. So there is something called as other schedulings, right? So build after other projects are built. When you select this one, so you need to give the project name. Okay. So let's say there is one more job you have created in your Jenkins. So once that is successful, trigger this one. So in that case, you need to give the name of that job here. Okay. This is also one of the type of build triggers. And also one more is like GitHub hook, a trigger for Git SCM polling. So this I have discussed in one of my other videos. Like this we will call it as commit based job. Okay, so wherein like whenever there is a commit in GitHub, so it will automatically trigger a build in Jenkins. So that time, if you want to configure that kind of jobs, then you need to use this particular option. Okay, so now let's see 1734 it is. So let's see whether the build has been triggered or not. As you can see, so now build has been triggered. So as you can see, started by an SCM change. So now if you go back to other console, like second console, it says like started by timer. So when it comes to third build, so it says like started by an SCM change. Means like when you enable poll SCM, so whenever there is a change in GitHub, then only it will trigger a job. So when it comes to build periodically, so whenever, I mean, it doesn't take, I mean, whether change your GitHub has a change or not. It, whatever the time you have given, it will trigger a build. So this is the basic difference between build periodically and poll SCM, and also other things also I have explained, right? Here if you see other options are there. GitHub hook trigger for Git SCM polling, so commit based job, and this like build after other projects are built. So if other build is successful, other job, so then if you want to trigger this job, so then you can select this one and give the name here. Okay. So this is about the difference between poll SCM and build periodically. And if you have liked the video, please share and subscribe. Thank you. Have a good day.